هيا على الفلاح.
We will be going through Prophet Ayyub alayhi salatu wassalam, known in the English language as Job. May peace be upon him. He was from the direct descendants of Ishaq alayhi salam, which means he came from the family of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. And his wife was one of the direct descendants of the Prophet Yusuf alayhi salatu wassalam. And her name, according to some narrations, was Rahmah. Rahmah. And his mother was from the descendants of Lut alayhi salatu wassalam.
Ayyub alayhi salam was sent to Huran, which is the south of Syria.
He was granted good health. He was granted lots of wealth. He was given livestock as well as large tracts of land. And he had many children.
And not only this, he was very well respected. Everyone respected Ayyub alayhi salam. Everyone looked up to Ayyub alayhi salam. Everyone took advice from Ayyub alayhi salam. People will gather around Ayyub alayhi salam to be part of the gathering of Ayyub alayhi salam.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to test Ayyub alayhi salatu wa salam, to see this worshipper of mine, who is in constant ibadah, who always thanks me, who always thanks upon all conditions. I want to see if the condition changes, does he remain on that same path of his. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided, Allahu Akbar, to take his wealth away. He lost his livestock, he lost his property, he lost his wealth, he lost absolutely everything.
From being so wealthy into being so poor, had not enough money to eat and drink. From being so wealthy with the law of wealth, with the law of God, with the law of money, with the law of jewelry, with the law of lands, with the law of houses, with the law of slaves, into nothing.
He was still thanking Allah. Ya Allah, I praise you on all conditions. Not a day did he complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And thereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to test him further. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took his offspring away one after the other. They were all gone. They all died in front of his eyes. All of them. And he had been given a lot. One after the other. With everyone, he would say, we all belong to Allah. Whatever he has given to us was always his. If he took it away, it just returned to who it belonged to always. He still says, Ya Allah, you have still given me. And I thank you, and I praise you, and I remain in your worship, and I continue with my work. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to test him finally with something very, very difficult. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, then we decided to take his health away. Firstly, the outward, and then the inside.
He became so sick, he became so ill, that people, as I mentioned before, people wanted to be around Ayyub. No one wanted to be around Ayyub. They used to get turned off or disgusted from the scene that Ayyub alayhi salam used to be in.
The people around him were saying, Allah doesn't love this man. If Allah loved him, this wouldn't have happened to him. And he continued, he says, never. I know that when Allah tests a person, he tests him this way as well. And he continued and he persevered until there was a time when nothing was operating besides his heart and his tongue. And he still used that tongue to remember Allah. And he still used that heart. He never allowed it to lead him to frustration against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
No wealth, no food, lack of money, no kids, all dead. No one wants to be around him. The only one that stood by him was his wife. She helped him, she supported him. She had wealth and she spent all that money in trying to heal Ayyub alayhi salam, in trying to get medication for Ayyub alayhi salam, for bringing food to Ayyub alayhi salam, until there was no more money. So what did she start to do? She started to work for people. And she'll earn her living from working for people, and then she'll use that money to get food for Ayyub alayhi salam. Later on, when the condition of Ayyub starts to worsen and people hear about Ayyub's condition, and this is the wife of Ayyub, no one dared to hire her. They're too scared from the sickness to be passed to them through his wife. So at the end, no one will dare to get near the wife of Ayyub or allow the wife of Ayyub work for him.
And one narration says that his wife, after some time, asked him a question. how long is this going to last? That made him so upset. Because to him, he was surrendering to the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he asked his wife a question. How long did Allah bless me with goodness? She looked at him and she said, 80 years. Now, how many years is he testing me for? She looked at him and she says, the last 7 years. So how do you want me to lose hope in the mercy of Allah when I haven't even reached par with what goodness I had and the difficulty I'm facing? It's not even equal. This is 7 years and that is 80 years of goodness. How can we become upset with Allah when He gave us almost a whole lifespan full of goodness? If I get better, I'm going to lash you 100 lashes.
Ayyub alayhi salam never used to complain and never raised his hands and said, Ya Allah, take me out of what I'm in. He was too shy to ask Allah for that. But, Ya Allah, give me patience. Ya Allah, give me strength. This is your test over me. You accept it, I accept it, and I'm having patience till then. And as we mentioned, his wife is also striving. His wife is also struggling. She wanted Ayyub to come out of the situation that he's in, so she could live a better life. Because she's striving to keep Ayyub alayhi salam alive, or she's striving to keep Ayyub alayhi salam comfortable, or she's striving to keep Ayyub alayhi salam in what he needs of his life, or what he needs from food, and what he needs from water, and the rest of the things. And when people start to find out that she is the wife of Ayyub, no one will accept her to be working for them. And now she needs money. She's got no money. And she needs food to feed Ayyub alayhi salam. For that food, she needs money. There's no money. So what did she do? She had the very long hair. And back then, they used to sew the hair. And she had the nice hair that she cut one of the sides of her hair. And she sold it to one of her friends. With that money, she bought food to Ayyub alayhi salam. Ayyub alayhi salam knew that she has no money. This day she came with food. Where did you get this food from? She did not want to respond to Ayyub alayhi salam because she knows Ayyub will get angry. And she was covered. So she mentioned that I was working, I made the living and I bought food with the money that I made. The next day she needs money. She spent the money for Ayyub alayhi salam on Ayyub. So she went and sold the rest of her hair. She shaved her hair off for the sake of selling that hair to get money to buy food for Ayyub alayhi salam and for herself. When she came to Ayyub alayhi salam, this time Ayyub insisted on her, where did you get the money? Ayyub knows that no one is accepting her to work and she was complaining to him. Where did you get this money from? He insisted on her until he made the promise that she's going to tell him the truth. She uncovered her hair when Ayyub saw that scene.
He calls out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, وَأَيُّوبَ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. Remember when our servant Ayyub called out to us, telling us that, Oh my Rabb, evil has touched me. Evil has touched me. And yet you are the most forgiving, most merciful. Which means, cure me, Ya Allah. You are most merciful and evil has touched me. Your mercy will dictate to remove that evil. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. We responded. How? وَاذْكُرْ عَبْدَنَا أَيُّوبَ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الشَّيْطَانُ بِنُصْبٍ وَعَذَابٍ. Remember our slave when he called out to his Rabb. He called out to say, look, shaitan has definitely harmed me with this and that, with difficulty, with hardship, with sickness, in wealth as well as in health. Loss in wealth as well as health. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we told him when he was standing, أُرْكُضْ بِرِجْلِكْ هَذَا مُغْتَسَلٌ بَارِدٌ وَشَرَابٌ. Strike the ground with your foot. This is cold water for you to wash yourself with and to drink. So he struck the ground with his foot. A spring gushed. Water, cold water, started gushing from his feet. So as he washed, his blisters started disappearing. As he drank, the internal organs came in order again. To the degree that in a short space of time, his skin was renewed totally. Renewed totally. A new man. Allahu Akbar. And his internals were made again as good as they were before, and even better by drinking this water.
His wife comes, she was looking for Ayyub alayhi salam, and she asked, did you see that righteous was servant of Allah Ayyub sitting around here? But Allah, he looked very close to him and was healthy. So he responded back to her, smiling, saying, it's me. So she didn't believe him. She said, Are you making a mockery? Are you making fun? Where is he? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me the health. Allah azza wa jal gave me the health again. And he was, Ayyub alayhi salam, healthy and fit and strong as he was.
وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ أَهْلَهُ وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ رَحْمَةً مِنَّا وَذِكْرَى لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ.
After that, not only did we return his health to him, but his family, we gave back family members double than what he had before. In a short space of time, Allah says, we gave him double what he had before. And Allah says, we gave it to him as a blessing from us and as a reminder for those with sound intellect, those who want to take heed. And as he is bathing, and this hadith is in Sahih al-Bukhari, as he is bathing without his clothes on, he is bathing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent locusts that fell from heaven, from Jannah. And they came, pure gold locusts falling. And he started gathering them. And he was thankful to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks him, oh Ayyub, you know we will take care of you. Why are you gathering these locusts? He says, ya Allah, this is mercy from you. I must gather it. Subhanallah. He had one issue, one more issue. He swore that he would lash his wife 100 lashes if he was cured. Now he's cured. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to him,
وَخُذْ بِيَدِكَ ضِغْثًا فَاضْرِبْ بِهِ وَلَا تَحْنَثْ.
Allah says, don't break your promise. He will show you a way out. You can take a little bunch full of grass-like branch, very light, and use that to whip, Allah says. So imagine now you're taking a bundle of little grass and you're using that. It has no pain, but you are not breaking your promise. Look how Allah taught him a way out of this. Because he was genuine. He did not make a qasam for some silly reason, but it was because of Allah and because of his love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah showed him a way out.
Inna wajadnahu sabira ni'mal abdu innahu awwab.
We found him to be very patient. What an excellent worshipper of ours. Indeed, he was oft returning to us. Until we meet again, wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad, subhanallahi bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu.